Gratitude to all of you for joining us here tonight to celebrate Nigeria's 55th Independence Day anniversary. Let's hear it for 55 years. By way of a little history, as a British colony, Nigeria became a federation first in 1954, and increasing degrees of internal self-governance was introduced by the British until the country became fully independent on the 1st of October, 1960. Now, you might need to help me with the pronunciation of this name.
Go for it.
Dr. Nnamdi Azikiwe, okay, was installed as Governor General of the Federation, and Tafawa Balewa as Prime Minister and head of a democratically elected parliament.
Well, Suzette, tell me, have you been to Nigeria?
No, but I would like to go one day.
Just don't go with Alhaji, go with me. Do you know how Nigeria got its name?
No.
Well, let me tell you.
Thank you.
In 1890, a British reporter named Flora Shaw suggested that the country be named Nigeria after the Niger Delta that flows through it. The River Niger originates from Guinea, and it flows through Mali, Niger, entering into Nigeria at the northwestern tip of Kebbi State. It bifurcates in Kebbi State into Benue River and continues down south into the Niger River. So that's how Nigeria became Nigeria.
Wonderful. Has anyone here ever been to the Niger Delta or gone across the Niger River?
Sure.
Yes, maybe a few? How wonderful. Well, I know there's another claim to fame for Nigeria. It is the most populous black nation in the entire world. Did you know that? Yes? Its population at independence was 45.9 million people. But according to the United Nations Population Division, Nigeria's population was an estimated 178 million in 2014, making it the seventh most populous nation in the world and Africa's largest nation by population. And according to the United Nations, the population of Nigeria could double by 2035. Nigeria has 36 states and a federal capital located in Abuja. The current head of state is retired General Muhammadu Buhari.
Well, you're doing so great.
Thank you.
Yeah, man. You know, Suzette, as a Nigerian, I have to tell you that when two or more Nigerians gather, the discussion often reverts to the state of the Nigerian nation. Nigerians, just like Jamaicans, are very critical of their state and very, very frustrated sometimes by the amount of corruption that goes on. But I think that we often lose sight of the many achievements of our nation. According to the Houston Chronicle, the recent US census data shows that Nigerian immigrants have the highest level of education in the United States, surpassing whites and Asians. Although the Nigerian community make up a tiny portion of the US population, 17% of all Nigerians in this country have a master's degree.
Wow.
And you know, a typical Nigerian has 2 degrees.
Wow,
so
smart.
That's very
impressive.
Yeah. So throughout this evening, we will bring you questions, facts, and fun about Nigeria, which we shall title, Did You Know? Ladies and gentlemen, It now gives me great pleasure to invite Charles and Rachelle Louisin for the rendition of the national anthems of the United States and Nigeria national anthem. Please rise for the national anthems.
And blessing of the food.
Good evening, everyone. We are here, it's a happy day. A lot has been said. We are here to celebrate our Independence Day. And I call those who believe and those who do not believe, usually we pray before we eat. So I call on the Lord, Jesus Christ, who has done that for us, to bless this food so that we will enjoy it and partake on it and be happy with the nourishment. And we ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chief. You don't be careful. Chief, you must know that we are very hungry. That's why you gave us a very short break. You know, when we arrived this evening, I went to greet my Egbon, Femi, who introduced me to his friend. You know, white folks, sometimes when you put 7 o'clock on the invitation for Nigeria, you know, they have to know. So I was giving him the formula. I said, you know, next time, if you are going to a Nigerian event, just look at the time difference between the American time and the Nigerian time, minus 3 hours GMT, that's when you arrive. So right now, it's about, 2 o'clock in Nigeria, minus, that's the formula done, okay? Libation is an African tradition and ceremony that is conducted at the beginning of any special event or occasion to invoke or in remembrance of our ancestors. The tradition of pouring libation, Suzette, is very spiritual and is revered because it has its roots in African ceremonies. It is done then, and it is done now, to honor our ancestors and those who are no longer here with us in person, because their lives were exemplary and it matters to us. The most elderly person, or a chief, or a designate, does the honor of pouring the libation. We are blessed tonight to have the chairman of the Nigerian American Foundation, who is also an African chief and a community leader here in South Florida. Please welcome on stage Chief Joseph Obadeyi.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. From time immemorial, if you go back to those of us who are Christians here, to Genesis chapter 35, verses 14 and 15, is the first time a libation was poured, whereby Jacob spoke with God. And after speaking with God, he poured an expensive oil on a stone, and the place became Bethel. Libation is not something that only Africans do. This is something that is universal. Universal in the sense that to invoke the presence of our ancestors, to partake in anything that we do libation. Even in the hip-hop culture, you will say when the homies get together and get the malt liquor shells, they will pour a little bit down and say to the homies that are no longer with us or those in jails or wherever they may be, this is the same thing we're doing tonight. We are bringing those that are not here with us, our ancestors, to partake in what we are doing. And to do it, I will do it in the way, because one of our ancestors, the King of Benin, always said that I will always pray in the language of my ancestors until it is proven to me that God doesn't understand. And we all know that God is God of understanding. So, allow me to say this in the language that I'm more comfortable with. English is a borrowed language to me. And this night, I will do it in the language of my ancestors. Bear with me. So, ilo gẹda afoko yere alapote ka o ko tu ko ba fun gbogbo wa o ko ri ile ko ma ba to de je o ko ri ile ko ma ba to de je o ko ri ile ko ma ba to de je o eyi ta o se lale oni aseye ni o aseye ni o. Thank you everybody.
Thank you Chief Ashe. Ladies and gentlemen, at this moment, I want to introduce to you a man who works very hard each and every day for the Nigerian American and Nigerian diaspora here in South Florida. Since becoming a spokesperson for the NAF, he and his team have worked hard and continue to work hard and tirelessly to improve and protect the image of Nigerians and Nigeria. He has embarked on a personal crusade of marketing and outreach to other organizations in the community, and as a result, he's already bearing tangible fruit. Ladies and gentlemen, please give me a very, very warm welcome for NAF's president, Mr. Dr. Yinka Tele.
Presido.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I'm going to make my speech as short as possible because I don't want to be accused of standing between you and dinner. But it's still very important for us to tell you about some of the things that we are doing in the Nigerian American Foundation. So I'm going to read part of my remarks that is already published in this souvenir journal. On behalf of the Nigerian American Foundation, I'm delighted to welcome you to the 55th Independence Anniversary of Fight the Nation, being marked with the Green and White Banquet and Awards Gala in this beautiful Biscayne Bay campus of my alma mater, Florida International University. I wish to especially appreciate our partners, the African and African Diaspora Studies Department of this great institution under the inspired leadership of Dr. Oyeyi Jane Mutaba, who was earlier in this hall. I think I saw him, but he's probably, just stepped out. They have graciously availed us the use of this venue for this occasion. With more than, I would skip that, you can read that later. Other activities that we have lined up in celebration over a 2 week period include the Nigerian History and Spelling Bee competition held at Miami-Dade College, North Campus, on Saturday, September 26, 2015. And the showcase of Nigerian, actually the president of Miami-Dade College North Campus, Dr. Malu Harrison. I saw her just now as I was coming up the days, looking very resplendent in green and white. Please give her a round of applause. We also have a showcase of Nigerian arts, artifacts and lifestyles at the lobby of the Stephen P. Clark Government Center in downtown Miami from October 3 to 15, which will be climaxed with a formal county commission ceremony recognizing Nigeria, scheduled for 10 a.m. next Tuesday. I invite all of you to come and celebrate with Nigerians in South Florida at this recognition ceremony by the commission. It's going to be presided over by the mayor. Tonight's fundraising banquet with the theme Promise of a New Nigeria will benefit NAF's Kill Malaria Initiative in Africa and Kids of Promise Scholarship Fund. We are recognizing also some of our community leaders, including Dr. Harrison, President of Miami-Dade College North Campus, Mr. Don Campion, President, Banyan Year Services, Mr. Xavier Murphy, Jamaican.com founder, Dan Suleiman, a police officer and former vice president of the Nigerian American Foundation, Mr. Rodney Baltimore, a media personality, and Ms. Adama Osuji, an actress and entertainer with the prestigious NAF Heritage Awards. A Nigerian cultural enthusiast, Chief Nathaniel Stiles, will deliver the keynote address. This anniversary is taking place at a time that the Nigerian
American Foundation Re-Engineers and Refocuses to build vital partnerships with entities such as the Diaspora Arts Coalition, the North Miami Beach Medical Center, Mercy Mobile Clinic, Nothing But Nets, FIU's Africa and African Diaspora Studies Department, and of course, Miami-Dade College North Campus. We also recently amended our constitution to make our organization more reflective and inclusive of all the components of the 2,000 plus strong Nigerian community in South Florida. On Sunday, July 5, 2015, the General Body of NAF approved the creation of two new categories of membership as part of this process. First is organizational membership with annual dues of $250 per annum. Under this arrangement, subscribers to member organizations automatically become associate members of NAF, benefiting from the services of NAF's affiliated free clinic and other discounted services. Second is a student membership category with annual dues of just $50 for individuals who are in the process of obtaining their first vocational or academic degrees in the United States of America. I humbly invite you to join us to help build a strong and respected African voice in the Tri-County area of South Florida. We envision a thriving, unified, and progressive community that is culturally aware, professionally and economically equipped, and politically potent. Visit us at www.nigerianamericanfoundation.com to learn more about us. Together we can, and we make a difference. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you, Dr. Tella.
Thank you, Mr. President, for that inspirational message. Nigerian Americans are part of the mosaic of immigrants that enriches the multicultural diversity of South Florida. Nigerians are the single largest contemporary African immigrant group in the United States, and it is estimated that more than 20 million people of Nigerian descent reside outside of Nigeria, with the biggest population living in the United Kingdom and the United States. Additionally, the Nigerian diaspora has established itself in every sphere of life in the world, and especially here in the United States. The Nigerian diaspora maintains a long tradition of friendship, interaction, and successes in the US, and they continue to contribute and excel in every field of endeavor, including the arts, academia, business, public administration, sports, film and entertainment, healthcare, trade and commerce, and socio-economic development. Now I know, Suzette, the only thing you will say that, yeah, Jamaicans are the fastest in the world. You know, but I have to ask you, what is the secret?
I think it's that good yam we got.
I think it's in the ackee.
The ackee is the fish. How wonderful. Well, as Dr. Tella told us about so many wonderful things that NAF or NAF is doing, I wanted to share a small fact about Dr. Tella. His exemplary leadership and hard work have not gone unnoticed. He is being honored to receive the Community Ambassador Award in the category of public service by the Diaspora Arts Coalition at an awards gala to be held on October 24th at the Miami Shores Country Club. Let's hear it for Dr. Tella. If you would like to join him there, we invite you to join that celebration on the 24th. Please see Desmond, he has additional tickets for that gala, so we want to get you from one to another. And again, we are so proud of the work he's doing on behalf of Nigerians right here in South Florida. Well, it's about that time. It smells really good, right, Desmond? Are you guys hungry? Not yet? No? Yes? Kind of? It's okay, we're family now. We can share these things. Well, it is definitely time for us to partake. Dinner will be served buffet style. There are two. They are the same on both ends. You see one here. We'll see one there, and we'll start with the outer tables, the tables closest to the buffet, and then work our way in. Please enjoy.
Thank you. Enjoy your dinner. For those of you just joining us, welcome to the 55th Independence Anniversary of Nigeria, and we'll be back shortly to continue the show. Enjoy your dinner.
You may be served. These three tables here, please start, and these two, as well as the third one on this side, may start at the other side. Thank you.
And we'd like to give thanks to our servants from the Miami Job Corps and Sydney Goklas, the chief instructor. Thank you for availing us with the service of your students. Thank you.
Bon appetit. We'll be back shortly.
Oh, he doesn't know the sun.
Gentlemen, did you enjoy our fashion show? Yeah. Let's give it up for designer Anne Ojo and International Fashions. Thank you. Wonderful job. Gorgeous, gorgeous fashions tonight. She's an excellent designer and she'll be around, yes? If you like anything you saw, yes? You can see her. Please take a bow. Please wave to our audience. We are so happy. Let's hear it for Ms. Anne Ojo. So happy to have her fashions. Quite exquisite, quite beautiful. We are thankful that she joined us tonight with the International Royal Fashions. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So, oh my gosh, with all that great, beautiful, enjoyable fashions, it looks as like we're almost ready for a dance performance. But let me first ask you a little bit of trivia. Let's see who knows a lot or a little about Nigeria. Can someone tell me what the official language of Nigeria is? The official, it is? Okay, this sounds like a lot of disputes. But according to what we have, it is English. But do you know how many dialects are spoken there? Too many to count? How many? 250 dialects. Can you imagine?
Well, how many do you guys have in Jamaica?
I don't know. Well, our motto is out of many, one people. So I think it is very similar for Nigeria. Wonderful. Let me see. What else can I ask? Let's see. Do you know anything about the movie industry in Nigeria? Do you guys enjoy Nigerian movies? They are wonderful. Let's see. What internationally is Nigeria ranked as the largest producers of movies? We know that there is Hollywood. We know that there is Bollywood. And we know that Nigeria also has a very ferocious movie industry. What out of those top three, what do you think Nigeria ranks? One, two, or three? What do you think? Two? You think they'd be Hollywood? You think they're one? Who thinks one? Who thinks two? Oh. Okay, well, they go by Nollywood. Did you know that? Nollywood has recently been ranked as second largest producers of movies in the world, trailing behind India's Bollywood and ahead of America's Hollywood. How about that? Wow, film cap, we could go there and become movie stars. Did you know that?
Well, listen, actually your dreams may come true because we have Mr. Murphy's Law, who's actually a producer that produces Nigerian movies here in Florida.
Wow.
Murphy, are you looking for actresses?
Where is he, please?
She's interested. Oh. Okay.
All right, I might take a visit to Nollywood.
Just so you know, I'll have to be your agent.
Okay, please. Let's do one more.
Okay.
Who were the first Europeans to reach Nigeria? Who? From what country? Do we know? What would you guess? Some say what? British? Who else? Portuguese? Any other guesses? French? Okay, British, Portuguese, French. Well, the correct answer is the Portuguese, not the British, not the French, were the first Europeans to reach Nigeria in 1472.
Wow.
Wow. Interesting fact. Did not know that.
Yaman.
Yaman.
Okay. Well, we have a little piece of entertainment for you because, as you know, Nigeria is part of the region of ECOMOC called West Africa. So we thought it not robbery to invite our friends and sisters from Ghana
who
have a table to entertain us tonight. Please welcome the Ghanaian medley with Harriet and Patricia Sampson.
Come on, come on.
That's how I used to dance.
Oh, you used to dance like that? Okay.
Mr. Chairman, about there, I catch you. You were shaking it back there.
Uh-oh.
It's in the blood.
How wonderful.
Did you even see? Oh, Ibo was even dancing.
Oh, wow.
You know, Suzette, you are really, really... I saw you eating that jollof rice like you are in Nigeria or something.
It was delicious.
Have you done your ancestry and found out that your DNA is probably somewhere between Guinea, Ghana, and Nigeria?
I would not be surprised, quite frankly.
Just make sure you don't follow Alahaji. I told you were following me to Nigeria, not Alahaji. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, if I may please crave your indulgence to really listen to the person that we have chosen this year to be our keynote speaker. We said earlier on that sometimes we as Nigerians, we do not appreciate our country because of our personal experiences. You will be surprised that there are non-Nigerians who travel to Nigeria to study our culture and help us to propagate that culture all over the world. When I moved to Miami in 1991, I was privileged to know this person who I refer to as my friend, my brother, and my chief. He has even inspired me as a Nigerian to appreciate my own Nigerian culture. How is it that an African American will wake up one day, decide to travel to the Yoruba land, became a Yoruba chief, and has taken that experience all over the world to let the entire world know the richness of our culture? So, it is my pleasure, and I urge you to listen attentively to him, because you are about to discover the power and the influence of the Nigerian culture. There are those who not only seek knowledge about our customs and traditions, but they help us make sure that the entire world is aware of it. Please welcome our keynote speaker for tonight, my brother, my group friend, High Chief Nathaniel Stiles.
Good evening, everyone. It's indeed an honor and a privilege to address you this evening. And whenever I hear an African American, I somewhat cringe, because we say the river never forgets its source. Your children who are born in America, they're just as Nigerian as you are who are born on the continent. One of the things I can very proudly say, although we are Africans born in America, I have the very unique privilege and honor of us owning the land that our ancestors are born on. So, and they're buried there today. So I'm one of the few Africans born in America who indeed knows its history. Not just that, but the tradition of ironwork, which is an attribute of Ogun. It is my family that has the patent, the trademark, for the hammer and the nail extracting device. So indeed, I am a son of the soil, and I honor and pay tribute to all of the Africans who lost their lives in the process of the Middle Passage, to all the mothers, Eva, to all the fathers, to my mother, who was one of the first African Americans employed by Eastern Airlines in their corporate office in reservations. And she planted the seeds within me to have a passion to explore the world, to embrace people, and to rediscover my heritage and identity. I also honor Olorogun Michael Ebrew and his late wife, Elsie Nelly Ebrew. They were the first people to invite me back home. And my very first experience on the continent, I had the privilege of traveling in the Ebrews' plane, at that time Aero Contractors, which has now become one of the major airlines in Nigeria. So what I will say is that I've been blessed not just to return home, but to be embraced by some of the most powerful and prominent people on the continent. So I salute them, I honor them, and I honor you for giving me this great privilege to be here. When Dr. Teller asked me to speak on identity development, cultural consciousness, and the Nigerian diaspora, the most personal thing I could reflect upon is my recent experience with a PBS and BBC documentary team called Sacred Journeys. What was so special about Sacred Journeys is, was the very first time that the Yoruba or any African experience spiritually was documented along with Hajj, along with pilgrimages to Jerusalem, to India, to Japan, and in this instance, for the very first time, Nigeria was elevated as a World Heritage pilgrimage, and that was to Osun Osogbo. So we had the privilege of being filmed for about 6 weeks, both in Miami as well as in Nigeria. And based upon that experience, what I'd say is probably the most significant tool for helping to reinforce cultural identity in Nigeria, to help stimulate and develop the economy, as well as creating a sense of awareness, is to embrace the brothers and sisters in the diaspora, who, despite the centuries of separation, the atrocity of the slave trade, have strived and sacrificed to preserve this ancient tradition and culture. I've had the privilege to travel to Haiti and to interact with Yoruba people in Haiti and Brazil and to Trinidad and recently Cuba. We've had the privilege to be there 6 times already this year. And you'd be very, very surprised to know that the traditions of Africa are very, very much alive in these developing countries. So one of the greatest assets, one of the greatest things that we can do as a people of color is to hold on to our culture. Because at the rate things are developing, there will be people who don't look like us physically, who indeed are the keepers of our customs and traditions. Normally I speak as I'm speaking now, and the children at home encouraged me to use my iPad and to take some notes. Believe it or not, I use the iPad and it's on the table. The notes I put there disappeared. So I do have bits and pieces on my phone. We would talk about the diaspora. People hear that term and really don't have a point of reference as to what it is. The diasporas are movements of people in time and space. They embody at once both trauma and creativity. They are expressions of power and dislocation, of loss, gain, of family. Of loss, gain, of family, and strangers engaged in dances of history, culture, and evolution. Diasporas are sources and resources for renewal and dissipation, conflict and resolution, tradition and revolution, all bound by the leaven of human experience. So once again, the most significant thing we can do as a people is to embrace those who embrace us, those who are the custodians of our ancient customs and traditions, the stories of our fathers, mothers, grandmothers, grandfathers. This is the key to our future. And when we really go into a much deeper level, there is a Odu of Ifa that gives us a direct reference to what we're experiencing right now. And I'm going to share that with you and I'll close out. A narrative in Odu Ifa, which establishes communication between gods and men, expounds upon the consequences of poor leadership, rulership. So the greatest problem we're having is with our leadership. And when we say leadership, normally we're pointing like this, and we say when you point one finger out, the remaining four are pointing towards yourself. So we indeed must take control of our communities, of our family, and reinforce the positive values that are necessary for the sustenance of our people. According to the town of Motukeke, was ruled by a king named Dead from the neck up, who turned the regency inside out. As a result, people lost their way and forgot their appointed roads. That is, they forgot their life purpose, at which the core of the Yoruba worldview is to maintain balance and harmony among human beings. The Odu Ifa says, The world is a simple place. It is a place where confusion of the miseducated have created problems. The creator made things simple to confuse the fool. Obviously, dead from the neck up refers to a senseless behavior, lack of emotional intelligence, social progress, and political savvy. Restoring balance and harmony is a major theme in Odu Ifa, which seeks to understand the context and circumstances that create imbalance and disharmony in order to return to social equilibrium. In Odu Ifa, we choose which path to follow by choosing whether or not to make the necessary sacrifice to achieve that equilibrium. The wisdom of ODFI inspires me to ask, what role does Pan-African behavior consciousness have in our development and our preservation? The legacy, lived, and experiences available to guide us now, how will they engage us? We assert that Africans, irrespective of our various names, must reclaim our appointed road by actively reclaiming our primary intellectual leadership position in Africa globally. Thank you.
Inspiring words. Thank you. Let's hear it one more time for our keynote speaker.
Hi, Chief Nathaniel B. Styles, Jr.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You know, I have to tell you, for someone who have been in the United States for more than three decades now. I've been here for 30 years and moved down to Miami, Florida about 25 years ago. The Nigerian community has made tremendous strides. The Nigerian community is the first of the African community to have an elected office, and which is Dr. Irabo Igodaro in the city of Miami Gardens. There is no other African nation that can claim that. So we have produced the first elected African in all of South Florida. Following his footsteps, we have tonight all the way from Palm Beach, and please, you must do whatever it takes to support our sister. Miss Tina is running for the state office. Ms. Tinu Pena. Tinu Pena is running for the state office. So we want to make sure that we elect our own sister to represent us so that we can also have a voice, not just in Miami Gardens, not in Miami-Dade, but at the state level as well. Ms. Pena, please.
That's all right. Thank you so much for being with us tonight. Yeah. All the best for your election.
Yeah. So please, you know how it takes. You know what it takes. You know, it takes money. And she is really, really looking forward to your help to make sure that we have a voice. Now, the Nigerian community also is the first non-for-profit organization in Miami-Dade County to receive a county land to build a Nigerian museum. And this is an ongoing effort. Not even the Cubans, not even the Haitians have received a free land from the county to build their own museum. And so—
That is excellent, yes.
And so we want you to join, which is AMAC. In fact, we thought that this shouldn't just be a Nigerian thing, it should be an African thing. So it was named the African Museum of Arts and Culture. And we encourage you to join the 1000 Club for the establishment of the AMAC. And of course, Chief Obadeyi is the chair of AMAC, and Dr. Irabo Igodaro is the executive director. We must break ground within 5 years, otherwise the land reverts back to the county. So please help us to make that a reality. Talking about breaking ground, Dr. Teller, who just happens to be my neighbor, is everywhere. I don't even know whether he sleeps anymore because he really is working hard to put the Nigerian community on a much higher pedestrian. So this year, as part of the 55th Nigerian anniversary, he has struck an accord with the Miami-Dade County government to have a Nigerian display of artifacts in County Hall. This is the first time Miami-Dade County government will give us
the lobby of the government center in downtown Miami to display anything, arts, whatever, artifacts on county property. And so the chairman of that project is no other than my second neighbor, Mr. Danladi Suleiman, who's chairing that project. And they really want to make Nigeria proud. I told Dr. Teller, you know, I have some old hats and everything that I used to wear when I was in Nigeria. I said, no, we're not interested in old stuff. So they went all the way to bring a Nigerian renowned curator from North Carolina, Adewale Adenle, who's the curator, assistant professor of Appalachia in the state of North Carolina University. And the Nigerian artifact and artworks is donated for the exhibition showcase by Juliola African Marketplace in Miami Gardens. So the Nigerian community is moving forward. The train has left the station. Please join the bandwagon and make us proud. We invite all of you to come to the Miami Downtown Government Downtown Center on October 6th, where the entire Miami-Dade mayor and the commissioner will unveil the Nigerian exhibition, and it will be there from the 6th for 2 weeks to the 15th. No other African community has been given that privilege. So Dr. Teller, I have to give it to you.
Yes, sir. Let's hear from Dr. Teller once again.
You are moving us into a place that we've never been before. Congratulations to you and to your team. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce one of our own sisters from Haiti, and she has been a voice for the Nigerian community. All of the advocacy, when we travel to Tallahassee, she receives us and makes sure that our issues are placed before the state and the governor. And she's here to bring personal greetings on Nigeria's 55th anniversary. Please welcome my friend and sister, the Honorable Daphne Campbell, State Rep 108. Bonsoir, mes chers amis. Soyez la bienvenue chez nous. J'espère que tout va bien. Venez partager quelques mots avec nous. You want to not a
Good evening, everyone. Ikabo hum deho sanuda zua. Ah, you see, I know something in that jail. Before I start, let me call one of my residents, my constituent, my friend, President Malu Harrison. We're gonna do it together because everything I do, I always do it with my constituent. President Malu, can you please come forward, please? This is the president of Miami-Dade College, not campus. Give her hands, please, because she's doing a great job. As a woman, woman in power in Miami-Dade College. But she's beautiful, huh? This is President Malu Harrison from Miami-Dade North Campus. She is there for all of us, for Haitian, for Nigerian, for African, you name it, okay? So if you have any problem, please reach out to her. And even if you don't have no papers, she makes sure she puts you to college and you graduate. I'm telling you, give her hands. I'm telling you, she has done it for me. She has a lot of Haitian students who don't have nothing. And I reach out to President Malu, and some of them already nurses, you know, you pharmacists, you name it. President Malu, on behalf of my district, you know, I'm here to say something to the Nigerians, and but you're gonna be one of them too. Look at how you dress like Nigerian, huh? So on behalf of all my Nigerian people, we say thank you to you. All right. So tonight, let me say something. My name is Daphne Campbell. For those who don't know who I am, I'm from State House, and I heard you're running for office.
Yes.
Which district is that?
District 86.
86, that's Mark, Dave.
Mark Pafford.
Mark Pafford? Oh, girl, I'll be with you. Anyway, I need you in Tallahassee. I'm Daphne Campbell, like I said, State Representative District 108. I represent everyone from Tallahassee to Miami. And I've been in office since 2010. I've been a good friend of all Africans, not Nigerian only, every one of you. I am a good friend. And I'll be there for everything you do. This is tonight. I wasn't feeling well all day, but I say I can't miss this. What even I'm sick or not, I have to stand here. You see how only two people clap? So that means you don't have to be here. Thank you. And truly, I could tell you, I'm the hardest worker in Tallahassee. I'm the hardest worker. I have four offices, and in all four offices, I've been working hard. Every day. Every day. My office opened 9 to 5, Monday to Friday. And I worked on Thursday from 10 a.m. to 2 a.m. Tell me who works from 9 to 2 in America. None. But Daphne Campbell does. Because I'm here to help my people. But I'm here tonight to really give my greetings to all of you who are celebrating 55 years, you know, being Nigerian. And I could say 55 is a big number, but it's a small number for me. And I'm wishing you guys triple of 55. Triple of 55, and be happy. We all Nigerian, and proud to be a Nigerian. I am not one, but I'm gonna adopt. I'm gonna get my TPS tonight, not green card. I'm gonna get my TPS as a Nigerian. Don't you guys wanna give me my TPS tonight? President Malu, don't you want your TPS as well? Okay, both of us gonna get TPS. How many of you gonna give us our TPS tonight? Temporary status as a Nigerian. And next year when I come back, I got green card. And the following year, I'm gonna have my citizenship as a Nigerian. How's that? So God bless you all. I love you all. And I had a resolution here. And I think President Malu, as a president of Miami-Dade College, she's gonna read it. That's why we both of us gonna do this tonight. How's that, President Malu? You don't have no glasses. You see, she says she don't have no glasses. So can I get a volunteer?
Dr. Teller, will you come forward to receive this, please?
Oh, where is he?
Dr. Teller, I think it would be most appropriate that you come forward to receive.
Come with us. Okay. He's coming? Okay. Oh, I didn't see you. I was going to call you.
You want me to read it?
Mr. Malu, we're not finished yet.
Okay. Go ahead and read it.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Can you please read it, please?
Whereas, following British colonial rule that began in the 19th century, Nigeria became formally independent federation in 1960, and today Nigeria is the world's 20th largest economy. And whereas, often referred to as the giant of Africa, with over 177 million people and 250 ethnic groups, the Federal Republic of Nigeria is one of the most populous countries in the continent of Africa. And whereas, based in Miami, the Nigerian American Foundation was established on June 2nd, 2002, with the goal of promoting, protecting, and projecting the image and interests of the Nigerian community economically and politically. And whereas, from September 26th to October 15th, 2015, the Nigerian American Foundation will celebrate the 55th anniversary of Nigeria's independence with competition, a showcase of Nigerian arts, artifacts, and lifestyle, the Nigerian American Wellness and Cultural Fest, the Nigerian Independence Soccer Tournament, and the Green and White Banquet and Awards Night, and whereas the Nigerian American Foundation celebration will benefit the foundation's Kill Malaria and Access to Clean Water initiatives in Africa.
Yes, yes, yes.
Now, therefore, be it respectfully proclaimed that the Nigerian American Foundation and all of its participants are congratulated on the occasion of the 55th anniversary of Nigeria's independence, and the Nigerian American Foundation is commended for its sponsorship of this important and celebrated community event. Signed, Daphne Campbell, State Representative, District 106, this Saturday, 108, Saturday, October 3rd, 2015. Wait, did Malu want to say something first before?
Good evening, everyone. And I follow our state representative, Daphne Campbell, in conveying congratulations to everyone. Happy 55th independence to Nigeria. And Dr. Tella, and to the board of NAF, the Nigerian American Foundation. This is an absolutely outstanding event. And I know that apart from the event, you are doing outstanding work in the community to again uplift the people of Nigeria, both here and at home. So congratulations to everyone, and thank you for being here. And State Representative Daphne Campbell, thank you for your leadership and your work on behalf of the people of Florida.
Thank you, congratulations. Please step forward and take a picture together. Dr. Teller, you can step forward just a moment. Step forward. Go ahead, step forward so we can get a beautiful picture. Say a few words, Ms. Tina Pena from District 86.
Good evening, everyone. Actually, it's Chinwade Olufunke Akinka Pena. So, I'm Wegda. I am proud to be standing before you as a Nigerian celebrating our 55th anniversary. I grew up in Lagos, and I can tell you, I've seen what it takes to start from the ground and work your way up. So I'm running for Florida House of Representatives because I think we truly need to have a voice in Tallahassee, not just as a Nigerian, but as Africans, descendants, and minorities in general. So I wanna congratulate Dr. Tella and the Nigerian American Foundation for the great work that they're doing to bring cultural awareness about what Nigeria is about, the beauty of our culture, and what we as people of Nigeria have to offer to this great state. I thank you for embracing me, and I look forward to your support as I put all I have to into this race to win it in 2016. Thank you.
Thank you, and best of luck. Thank you very much. Wow, we have a lot of leadership in the house. I'm really excited about this next generation of what it will do here in South Florida and for the Nigerians back home. I'm really excited to see the contributions to our environment here, our political environment here.
Thank you.
For Deluxe Percussion!
Whoa!
Did you see when he laid down and played it over his head? Sat on top of it, played it between his legs? Wow, he got skills!
Well, let me tell you, we discovered them first before American Idol.
Now let's hear it one more time for the gentleman, Deluxe Percussion! Excellent!
And one more time, a shout out to our brother, Adewale Adenle, and Mrs. Julala, African Marketplace, for the exhibition. Thank you very much. Please make sure you are in downtown Miami on October 6th to see the exhibition. Suzette, what do we have next?
I think they're ready now. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Akwa Ibom State Association Miami Chapter Women's Dance Troupe. Back up.
So, yeah! Miami Chapter, in no show! I'm
Thank you. 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 Thank you.
Let's hear it.
Akwai from Association of South Florida. Thank you. Mrs. Shola. Can you be there? Wow. I did want to tell her. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Gentlemen don't look like they want to stop. The gentlemen have joined the party.
Thank you, ladies. Thank you. Thank you.
Let's do it one more time. For the beautiful ladies of Agua Ibom State Association, Miami Chapter. Women's Dance Troupe. Thank you, that was wonderful. Absolutely wonderful.
Well, Suzette, did you see the dollars just flying?
Yes, I saw a lot of dollars in the air.
Yeah. In Nigeria, we call it spraying.
Spraying.
Do you guys do that in Jamaica?
Not so much, not in this fashion.
Because you are running so fast and you are running away from the money.
I see. That was wonderful.
Okay. We have to apologize to cut it because our honorees are beginning to leave. So we want to make sure that we get to them. If you don't hear the sweet voice of Rodney Baltimore tomorrow by 5 a.m., blame Dr. Teller because he has kept him here too long.
So we're going into our award segment and we are going to our first awards recipient.
And I'm going to invite the chairman, Chief Obadehi, and the president, Dr. Teller, to please come forward to do the honors. You know, there are three kinds of people, we are told. There are those who sit down and watch things happen. There are those who simply hope that things happen. And there are those who make things happen. Tonight, we want to honor those who make things happen in our community. Our first honoree tonight, are you ready? Okay. Yes,
here,
the plaques
please.
Are here. Please
time.
Come on
Thank
stage.
Mm-hmm.
Our first honoree tonight needs no introduction. All you have to do is tune your dial on the radio to Hot 105. Please welcome someone who is a true community activist, and he has received numerous awards. I mean, what can we say about our brother Rodney Baltimore? Our first honoree tonight is no other than media guru, radio personality, tonight's recipient of Nigeria's 55th Independence Award for all that he does for the African community, Mr. Rodney Baltimore. She rock in Versace. The only thing they give me Nike. That's the life she did fight to karate. Hey, I go in a Bugatti. Hey, I go buy a Ferrari. You don't get any choice but to marry. Hey, I go give you the khaki. Hey, take a picture, please. Hey, photo love. Come in, see, the good lady. Hey, photo babe.
First of all, I want to say thank you, thank you, thank you so much. I'm Rodney from Hot 105 on behalf of our company, Cox, which is Hot 105, 99 Jams, Easy 93, Hits 97. I want to thank the Nigerian community, particularly in South Florida, for giving me your Guru Award. It's been a pleasure doing events with you. I've learned a lot about not just the Nigerian culture, but our culture in general. And I'm very humbled because there are a lot of more deserving people that should receive this award, but I'm glad that you chose me at this time and at this year. I had a long speech. It's gonna be a short speech because I know that you have some entertainment coming up and we have some other honorees, but on behalf of Hot 105 Radio, I want to thank the Nigerian community, Dr. Teller, just the whole Aretha, just the whole host of other individuals for just recognizing some of the work that I do. I know that the museum is going to be something extraordinary. I'm looking at the Nigerian culture and the descendants of Nigerian. You're taking Hollywood USA by storm. This Martian movie stars Nigerian.
Yes.
That's coming out tomorrow. You've made some strides, not just in American basketball or American football. You look at all the athletes that are on the upswing, actors, actresses in science and culture. So thank you so much for allowing me to be part of you and for giving me this award. I thank you all.
Congratulations, buddy. Thank you. Thank you very much. Our next award recipient is for exemplary corporate leadership. And it will go to Mr. John Don Champion. He's the co-founder of Banyan Air Services, Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and executive director of Egbe Hospital in Nigeria that his parents founded. Don's parents were medical missionaries in Nigeria for 40 years, and he attended Hillcrest School in Jos. He grew up in rural environment in a village called Egbe, where his parents founded Egbe Hospital. Don and his wife, Sue Ann returned to Egbe and assembled a 5-year revitalization plan to rebuild the hospital, water supply, housing, and electric grid, re-equip the hospital, recruit staff, and implement best practices, and bring the department up to speed. Now, 4 years into the plan, with the help of hundreds of volunteers from the USA, the local community, and Nigerian businessmen, the hospital is once again becoming a beacon of hope and healing for thousands of Nigerians. They make 3 trips a year to Nigeria, and Banyan Air Services, a company he founded, continues to grow at the Fort Lauderdale Airport as well. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome this year's Exemplary Corporate Leadership Award recipient. It goes to Mr. Don Champion.
Good evening, everybody. We talked about the son of the soil. I was born in Nigeria back in the 50s, so was part of 1960 celebration. Dr. Teller said I could give you a little journey back to Nigeria. So if you want to look at the 2 screens, I'll take you on that journey. That's my parents, Dr. and Mrs. Campion. In 1950, they went to Nigeria. A surgeon, a nurse, and midwife. My mother was born in Garkida in Nigeria. My father's Canadian, and I was born in Nigeria. So we have quite a culture family. There I am there with my Nigerian friends and my sister. And I have 3 sisters. One is with me this evening, and also my Yao, my wife, is here with me. And we were all born in Nigeria, and I lived there till I was 18 years of age. This is the hospital that my parents founded in the small village of Egbe between Kaba and Ilorin. And that was 1952 when the hospital was first begun and the first school of nursing in Kwara State, which is now Kogi. My love for aviation came from Nigeria. back in the 60s and 70s, a mission called SIM had numerous small airplanes. And these little airplanes would come, land on the grass runway right beside the hospital and take us to school. You can see from class one primary school, we would go to boarding school. That love for aviation, after my training in Toronto, Canada, I moved to Fort Lauderdale. And at the age of 24, I started a company called Banyan Air Service. I called it Banyan because we had many banyan trees around the village of Egg Bay. Our small little company, we founded in 1979, and today it has grown to be a large company looking after many of the airplanes that are coming every day to Executive Airport in Fort Lauderdale. We are doing maintenance, fueling, a lot of electronics work of all types to many types of private and corporate aircraft. Then we went back. I took my wife to show her where I grew up. We went to the small village, and the hospital was just about ready to close. This is the hospital there. And we really felt that God had called us to come back, revitalize this hospital. For 5 years now, with a plan, we have come back to rebuild it. Of course, the road is still, you are doing much galloping on this road. And you see many different things. I'm taking you back to the forest in Nigeria because it's a very rural area where we are living in Nigeria. You see many things. We are always so welcome when we come to Nigeria. Every time we come to Egg Bay, we are met with a large, many villages, beating the drum and singing, welcoming us with gifts and showing their appreciation to be part of this project. It was wonderful to still see my mother's name on the house where we were born. And I went to see all of the chiefs. Many of the chiefs of the surrounding villages were my friends when I was growing up. And they went to their constituents and they came to help us clean up the compound. So all the grass, the bushes, everything was removed. Now the compound was coming back. That is the house where I grew up. And now we have now rebuilt about 20 houses there on the compound. We have gotten rid of many unwanted guests. And you can see how we have rebuilt many of the houses. The old kitchens, the new kitchens. And then again, taking down the old hospital, it was all of the community. Community is very, very involved. And they come sometimes 300 to 500 per day to help us. Even Alhaji Dangote gave us about 4,000 bags of cement. Also, doctor in charge of GLOW, he gave us our own mask at Enuga. We are making about 200 bricks per day, and now the old hospital is gone, and this is the new one. Building our own furniture from Fort Lauderdale, from our company, we have sent now number 17 containers. Containers of shipping materials to make the old wards now new wards. The old operating tables, new ones. The old laboratory now, new one. The ICU intensive care, now a new one. The X-ray is a new one. The operating room, new lights and so forth. Yeah, God has showed us much favor as we have put power, electricity, water, backup power, rebuilt many of the buildings, and as we are teaching Nigerians to be nurses, midwives, and we have the West African Family Physician Residency Program also there in the bush. And you can see where The reservoir has been resurrected, so we now have 24-hour water there. And even Governor Wada has come to congratulate the community for the work that we've been able to accomplish. We have a guest house for any of you that would like to come to visit us at Egg Bay. The patients are coming up to 2,000 per month now, and we are able to look after many of those rural farmers and those people living in that area. So we appreciate your support, and even the village got together and they made a runway. So we are hoping we'll soon have the same small airplanes coming. And there's an African saying that if you want to go fast, you go alone. If you want to go far, you go together. And together we can do it. Thank you.
Dr. Malu Harrison for quite some time, and I know that she has always been involved in African activities. As a champion of students, Dr. Harrison has served Miami-Dade College in various capacities since 1989, including Dean of Students, the College President's Chief of Staff, and Adjunct Professor of English as a Second Language. Prior to her tenure at Miami-Dade College, she served as a student affairs administrator at the State University of New York, Buffalo. She earned her baccalaureate, master's, and PhD degrees from the University of Buffalo, Florida International University, and Walden University, respectively. She is not only one who talks the talk, but she is one who walks the walk, as she exemplifies tonight by adorning a Nigerian outfit. Please welcome Outstanding Educational Leader Award recipient, President of Miami-Dade College North Campus, Dr. Malu Harrison.
Show it right across the globe. Just face your fears, only then it will go away.
Hey, 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 confronting, right now I'm confronting.
Good evening again, and let me say that I'd like to ask for another round of applause for Mr. Campion. Because your work truly exemplifies serving others. And I also want to thank Dr. Tella and the Nigerian American Foundation, also Desmond Alufahai, the delegation that we hosted from the University of Benin and the University of Benin Alumni Association was truly, truly an enlightening visit, not only for the university delegation, but also for Miami-Dade College's delegation that welcomed our visitors from Benin. So we do look forward to that MOU coming forward so that we can solidify and really formalize an agreement, a collaboration for our college and the University of Benin. So with that, let me thank everyone on behalf of Miami-Dade College North Campus. We serve 50,000 students at the North Campus on 27th Avenue and 119th. We offer baccalaureate degrees, associate degrees, and certificates. And truly, opportunity changes everything. And we saw that with Mr. Campion's efforts in Nigeria. And we see that also with education and how that changes lives. And Desmond, when you said that Nigerians are among the most educated, if not the most educated, certainly that is something to be very proud of. And I'm very proud to be an educator myself. And we welcome all Nigerians to our institution. As State Representative Daphne Campbell said, we welcome everyone. No matter what the background is, no matter where you're from, Miami-Dade College opens its arms to you. Let me also mention one of my sisters here in the audience from Broward College, Ms. Karen Lee Murphy, is here this evening. And our institutions are doing a tremendous, and Dr. Tella, also from Broward College. But our institutions are doing a tremendous job of providing educational opportunities to students, large numbers of students, tens of students. And so I urge you to encourage anyone that you may come in contact with, whether old, young, the more seasoned, it doesn't matter. There is a program and an opportunity for us to better ourselves through education. Thank you very much for this honor. I'm truly humbled. Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you. Our next honoree is for the Caribbean Star recipient. I like this one. And it goes to a Jamaican diaspora icon, Xavier Murphy. He developed the website Jamaicans.com in 1995 and was a pioneer for web-based communication for the Jamaican diaspora. Jamaicans.com was the first and only comprehensive website for Jamaicans on the internet. Jamaicans.com is the world's leading website covering news, travel, culture, and politics in Jamaica and the Caribbean. It is the third largest Jamaican website online first, and second places go to these popular newspapers in Jamaica, Jamaica Gleaner and the Jamaican Observer. Jamaicans.com has been an oasis online since 1995, and it is an authoritative source on culture, language, and current events, and a commentary for non-Jamaicans who frequent the website. Mr. Murphy is also a proud alumni of Jamaica College, and he is the current president of the Jamaica College Old Boys Club of Florida. He is also the co-founder and coordinator of the annual Anansi Festival event held in South Florida. Do you guys know about Anansi? Yes? Okay. He is the folk hero spider that I think it's a Ghanaian root story brought to the Caribbean in the slave trade. But he has so many awards and accolades. He is the top 50 South Florida leaders of the Caribbean community, and we are so proud to have him recognize him today as a part of the 55th anniversary. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage our Caribbean Star Award recipient, Mr. Xavier Murphy.
Humbled and honored, Dr. Tella and the Nigerian American Foundation to get this award. It's really an honor being here. Thank you. I am someone who loves culture. And, you know, when Yinka had called me up and said, you know, congrats, you've been nominated and you have won this award, I was like, well, for what? I'm Jamaican. I mean, you know, you're Nigerian. Well, he said, listen, we're brothers. Okay, and he has always said that, you know, we're brothers.
And he says, your work with the Anansi Festival, which he attends every year with his family, is, you know, he said, listen, you don't understand. You're joining the Caribbean and Africa together with the work you're doing with the Anansi Festival. And what the Anansi Festival is, it's a cultural festival that we talk about Anansi, which is not ours. We Jamaicans may believe it's not ours, but Anansi is from Africa. And Anansi and the spider and those stories are what the slaves used when they came to the Caribbean. It was what they held on to when they were in the Caribbean to trick the slave masters. And that story is from the continent of Africa. Now, we did Anansi Festival in Africa. We're hoping to get it to Nigeria at some point, and I'll talk to you, we'll talk to you about that. But we have had it in Ghana, and we have also had it in Kenya. And what was really amazing was just getting the feedback. One of the organizer in Ghana said, the children there could not believe that Anansi, their Anansi from Africa, is now in the Caribbean. And the same things the Kenyans say. They said, I can't believe that their Anansi. And what it shows is that we're one. That's what it shows. We are one. We may be in different locations, but we are one. The gentleman who was the key speaker, the chief, said it. We are one. So I'm humbled and honored by this award. Thank you very much. And I was really appreciative to see the culture. I love learning about culture. And I know one day my brother will be going to Nigeria together. Nice. All right, so thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Dr. Harrison, you will be glad to know that our next honoree attended Miami-Dade College, where she earned a diploma in health information management. You know, when we were picking these honorees tonight, we wanted to make sure that these were people who were actually making things happen, not just in our community, but beyond. Ms. Lolo Adanma Osuji is also known in the Nigerian community and all of South Florida as Ms. Hollywood. And that's because of her beauty. She is also known as Mrs. Nigeria in Miami because she won that pageant in 2009. But let me tell you, it's not only because she's beautiful, an actress, a model, and a designer. She could have taken all of that and gone home to sit down. But as we celebrate Nigeria's culture tonight, Mrs. Osuji has dedicated her time, her effort, and her life to recruiting, grooming, and equipping the next generation. Because she knows it's not about me. She knows it's not about her. She knows that it has to do with the next generation. More so when our children are not growing up in Nigeria and losing our culture. So to make sure that our culture is instilled in the future generation, she has set up the popular Umwama cultural dance group of South Florida, instilling the Nigerian cultural values and helping them to learn from generation to generation. Please help me welcome Mrs. Adanma Osuji, Mrs. Nigeria!
You're my African queen.
Just
like the sun lights up the earth, it lights up my life. The only one I ever see with a smile so bright. And just yesterday, you came around my way. You changed my horse and way with your astonishing beauty. Oh, you couldn't make a brother sing. No ordinary thing, a supernatural being. And no, you are brighter than the moon, brighter than the star. I love you just the way you are. And you are my African queen, the girl of my dreams. You take me where I've never been. You make my heart go ding-a-ling-a-ling. Oh, You are my African queen, the girl of my dreams, and you remind me of a thing.
Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. I think everything I have to say tonight, Mr. Desmond has already said it. But anyway, I really want to thank the NAF for really giving me this award. I'm really humbled and deeply, deeply appreciated. I want to thank my husband that has always been behind me. He's just there laughing, you know. He's always, always supported me for whatever I want to do. And my parents are sitting right there also. My mom, she has always also, you know, whenever we come out with your mama, she's cooking, she's doing a lot with them, you know. So I don't know what else to say than to say thank you. And also to the community, for all of you that has really showed support to our children, the future generation of our community and of Nigeria and America. Thank you all for really showing them the love whenever they are out, you know, anywhere dancing, you know, in different ways that you have really showed your support to them, morally, financially, advice, whatever. I really say thank you and I really appreciate you all. Thank you so much. And to my own mama girls, this is for you. Make some noise. Thank you all. Thank you all.
Award goes to the outstanding community leader. Mr. and if I may call you Dan Suleiman is one of the co-founders and the first vice president serving two terms of the Nigerian American Foundation. He also served two terms as general secretary of the association. Mr. Suleiman assisted in coordinating passport and visa reissuance renewal exercises conducted by the Nigerian Consular Missions in the United States of America for the Nigerian community in South Florida. He also assisted in the association's efforts to solicit and secure land allotment from the Miami-Dade County Commissioners for the construction, as we've heard before, of the planned African Museum of Arts and Culture, also known as AMAC Complex, in the city of Miami-Dade Gardens. He's a member of countless organizations, and you can see them printed in your booklet. But I'd like to specially mention that Mr. Suleiman is an accomplished law enforcement officer with the Miami-Dade Police Department. He's the first sworn Nigerian African on the department with approximately 20 years of service. He is currently a sergeant and has worked various assignments, including uniform patrol and general investigations. Sergeant Suleiman is a certified law enforcement instructor, a former police assessor, and a field trainer, among other gifts and talents. It is my honor to welcome to this stage our outstanding community leader recipient. Please give it up for Mr. Dan Suleiman.
But don't give my name anytime you find yourself in any issues with the police department. Even my family, they know that don't use my name. Well, on a serious note, it has been a pleasure serving the community. When the idea of the Nigerian American Foundation came into discussion, I was fortunate to be among one of those that were called to see what we can do to bridge the gap between our various ethnic associations, and most importantly, to be a voice in the community. And I did not go out there looking for any kind of participation, but I was conscripted. And I'm one also who believes in doing things. And in the process, people just say, every time something happens, well, you do it. And I found myself doing this over and over. On that note, I would say, please, the one thing I have seen in the community, we do not come together. And this is something, for the first time, I am happy to see that all the segments of the Nigerian community have been called, they responded. And that is a very positive sign. It is my hope and prayer that, listen to us, we are Nigerians, period. We need to interact with one another. There are a lot of people that are professionals here. We don't know who you are. So I would encourage now, let's have a listing of the Nigerian professionals here. I mean, it's not a crime for you to go to your fellow Nigerian that has a business for you to get their services. Every community does that. So we need to come together, find out who does what we can use, what kind of service you can provide, and we'll help each other grow. I know that also there are a lot of Nigerians that have done so much in the community. I cannot name them, but it's an honor very much to be chosen or be even considered, and at the end to be chosen to receive this award. What I've been doing, I'll continue to do it as long as I can. But we encourage others to please participate. And thank you very much.
Congratulations again, Mr. Suleiman. Congratulations, sir.
Thank you, Dan. Dan. Were you referring to me when you said don't call my name? Because you know every time I get a ticket, the first thing I do is call you. And I give him the number of the surgeon that has stopped me, and then, you know, he calls, and then all I know is, hey, gentlemen, be careful next time. Thank you, Dan, for... Please, let's give a round of applause to Dr. Teller and Chief Obadeyi. Thank you. And to
all of our recipients. Congratulations once again.
Absolutely.
Most certainly deserved it.
Thank you. You know, I think Dan said it, Dr. Harrison said it, and of course we saw what champion. And please, let's do Nigeria a favor, because there are many who will ask you, oh, how was it? Yes, did it start late? Yes, it did, you know. But please tell them that for once, you are proud to be a Nigerian. And there is nothing, you know. I go to, you know, Rita invites me and I go to the high school to talk about Nigeria, and I say, you know, I think we really need to be patient, because even in this country that has had independence for more than 300 years, they still don't have it right. 200 and something years ago, they had a civil war. And if you look at what's happening in Washington, sometimes you have to scratch your head to say, wow, this is supposed to be a civilized country. So there is nothing after tonight. I'm going to stand on the hilltops and proclaim how proud a Nigerian I am because of each and every award recipient tonight. And for all of you, please, give yourselves a round of applause, because you came here to be witnesses. Thank you. So, Mrs. Nigeria has told us that she wants to show us a piece of the culture from her girls.
I can't wait to see it. This will be a nice way to cap off the evening.
Okay. Mrs. Nigeria, are you ready for us?
Are you ready, ma'am?
She wants to show us a little bit of all her hard work with her girls. And I am quite sure you will crave indulgence for them to get ready and be here. And please start getting your $1 ready for spraying, because they have been up all night. They haven't done their homework for Monday, so we need to appreciate them, because tomorrow they're going to be doing their homework after church. So, yes. Samuel's call. Samuel's call. You have your job lined up for you. Make sure you see Mr. Champion before you leave, because you're doing the same thing. And I saw your chairman, Chief Arubiana. Yes, okay. Chief Arubiana is here.
They look like they are ready.
Omwoma Cultural Dance Group. Are you ready?
Oh, yes. We have photographs available outside. They are $10 only. If you would like your photograph taken, please make sure you get it before you leave today. And we want to make sure we support our vendors. Photographs will be available right outside in the lobby. Only $10.
Thank you for your continuing patience and indulgence. Are you ready?
Oh, no, they're sleeping now. No, 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 no. We have some young people that are...
Dr. Femi Adeniji, they say even if you don't have change, change is available, so don't worry.
they can break a 20, don't worry.
Yes. Federal Bank is there. So for those of you who have 50s, no excuses.
That's okay. We take 50s too.
Are you ready?
Oh, you can do better.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, please welcome the one and only, directed by our own Miss Hollywood, Miss Nigeria, Umuoma Cultural Dance Group of South Florida.
Let's hear it. Woo. Thank you.
Shocky, 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 sh champion. Ha, I'm the life of the party. Effing call me the bang, that's my name. In a club on the streets, I watch and see. Like a canine taking over that scene. Wait a minute, let me show you a good time. Party back with the rest of the mankind. Walk my play hard, that's the anthem. Allow me to introduce me, canine. Ha, wait a minute, let me show you. Many, many of the things I'm showing you.
Thank you.
Trouble, they are not in jail, they are not doing drugs. Thank you.
Thank you. Very talented ladies and gents.
Thank you. And please, let's continue to support them. Now, we know you are all itching to dance now. Suzette, you said you're going to show me your new Nigerian move.
We're going to see.
Okay.
I've learned a lot here this evening.
Okay. But before we do that, we have the last act of the evening, which is the official cutting of the birthday cake for the nation.
The 55th anniversary cake is now front and center. If you would like a photograph, please take it. It is gorgeously green and white. Lovely. We will do the cutting of the cake.
Dr. Ikwe, remove one from the carton now. Who they cut cake inside carton? He's afraid.
It is gorgeous.
Dr. Taylor, President, please, we invite you for the official cutting of the 55th anniversary cake that Dr. Ikwe refused to remove from the carton.
He's improvising. It is still quite beautiful. Happy anniversary. Happy 55.
Dr. Taylor, please, we are itching to dance, so please come and cut this cake. Let us eat it. Oh, you want the board? Okay.
Oh, members of the board, will you come forward? All the executives.
And all honorees.
All honorees still here. Please come forward.
All honorees, come forward. All executive board, come forward, please, for the cutting of the cake.
Let me also invite State Representative Daphne Campbell. Let me invite Ms. Tinu. Please come forward to. You have temporary status as a Nigerian.
TPS.
Come forward.
She have her work visa.
Dr. Harrison, all honorees.
Dr.
Please
Harrison,
come forward.
Representative Daphne Campbell.
Ms. Tinu, Campbell. Please join them.
Please, Ms. Tinu. Mr. Campion, we're going to get your name right. Campion, is it? Campion. Thank you.
Dr. Taylor, Dr. Igbe, I tell you now, say that they remove cake inside carton before they cut them.
Happy 55. Let's stand for a beautiful, gorgeous picture together as we celebrate this glorious anniversary.
All executive members of NAF, please come forward. All honorees, please come forward.
We'll have a picture here.
Mrs. Essien.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, get your cameras ready on three. All right, everyone. Who is missing? Where's Miss Taylor? Where is she? Call her.
Mrs. Taylor, please. Honorary Akwa Ibom dancer, please come forward.
Mrs. Taylor, we like you in this photograph, please. Please come forward. And then we'll cut it on three as soon as she joins the picture. Give us your best smiles. On three, we're gonna say happy 55th anniversary, Nigeria. Ready? One, two, three. Happy 55th anniversary, Nigeria. Congratulations,
hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hooray!
Hooray! How wonderful, yes, congratulations as we celebrate and cut our cake. Thank you all so much. This would not have been possible without each and every one of you. Thank you, thank you.
Okay, please, before you leave, make sure you see Miss Shirley. We have our silent auction at the back.
And you can also take a picture out front, just $10 to commemorate Rita, tonight.
Did we miss anything? Everything is...
Everything's good, we can dance now?
Oh. Well, well, well. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Suzette, it has been such a pleasure.
My pleasure.
Tonight with you. And I hope you all had fun, just like we did. Please drive safely to your respective destinations, and please don't drink and drive at the same time. But now we're about to get rid of all those calories from the cake. Dr. Tella is not done yet. What now, Mr. President? Okay, Suzette, our job is not finished.
Almost ready to party, almost.
There is one more performance that we missed.
Who was this?
Mr. Femi Adefemi is going to be so mad at us because we skipped him from the program.
Oh no, not intentionally.
So you have to give him a Jamaican hug because he's not going to accept my Nigerian bele, Ejoma Binu.
Oh no.
So you have to tell him, Ejoma Binu, sir. Ejoma Binu.
Ejoma Binu, sir.
Okay.
Good evening, yo. I only have 5 minutes, so you will just manage whatever you get. 5 minutes of just a little taste. Nigeria, Nigeria, oh, Nigeria, oh, Ojumore, Ojumore, Nigeria, Moyofumo, Moyofurami. Abeokuta ilu eba Ibenabe baby is you. If you don't wait on me, dog, bow. Chief of the day, he let me. I want everybody that, everybody, I want everybody that. Money, I bet, could I do it back? Even a baby, busy, yo. Even a better, me, that, oh. He let me, money, 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 my, oh. Lord, you, money, money, my, oh. Keep my own aggressive. Yeah? Yeah?
On your knee, oh yeah, John, your new baba.
Carry me out of here, guess what? Somebody studied our culture and is promoting it. I have to give something for you, and I'm going to give it to you because as a high chief, I give you something on Shango. And I hope you will like it. Shango!
Oh, yeah, my bum. Oh, yeah, my bum. Garo. Y'a le souci. Garo. Y'a le souci. Donné. Garo, c'est pas mon nom. Listen, only talk to only my son.